we're seeing right now. And Tracer, another one, wow. Brand new hero. Lingering Penguins really pulling out the odd picks. Not bad necessarily, but we'll have to see what they're going for here.
That, I think that is their response to the KT pick. They feel that a Tracer going after a KT will be advantageous for them. But we'll see. I'm not sure if that's going to be the case or not, but we'll see that. Now we have a Zul pickup by Avalanche. Very, very nice. I'm a huge fan of Zul. And getting him early like this, I think, is very, very smart on their end.
Yeah, it makes a lot of sense. He gives a lot of pressure in a lot of the lanes. You know, I'm a big proponent of making sure to have at least one Siege hero on your team that can counter push on Garden of Terror, where you make them choose how they lose, is the constant saying, where we see the Terror pushing in one lane, and then, you know, the four-man squad that's not in the Terror, you know, to roam somewhere else. So it really gives a lot of credit to Sylve, Zul, mm-hmm, Zagara, mm-hmm, you know, the biggest Siege heroes in the game. And speaking of which, there's Zagara. They are looking for some heavy Siege on this map.
Looking at this, they got Kael'thas with the Gravity, then Zul with the Prison, and then they took the number two response to a Zul pick, Zagara, and they're left with what, Sylvanas, who is very good for Penguins to pick up, but it really, you know, with a Zul and Zagara on the same team, is going to be very, very very, very tough, I think, especially with the XP. I think just looking at it so far, Avalanche is going to have the XP lead. At least that's my opinion.
Yeah, and they still have a ban here. You know, if they wanted, they could really choke hold the Siege position and maybe mm-hmm. ban out Sylvanas here. But either way, we're going to see Lingering Penguins come out with a Rhaegar ban as they try and kind of choke hold the healer picks. As, you know, the next picks for Avalanche seem like they're going to be pretty obvious. You know, you think they would pick up a healer and a tank to kind of round out their team. They got plenty of damage. They got all the Siege and the Burst with Kael. So what's missing for them is that tank and healer. So a healer chokehold kind of makes sense.
And I find it interesting that Penguins banned out Rhaegar instead of LT. Usually most people ban out a LT right away, but they do the Rhaegar ban because they're saying you don't have anybody that LT can stem on. For Avalanche, which is very, very interesting. And now we see a Sylvanas ban. So now they have been zoned out of the top three specialists in the game. They're left with Asmodan, Vikings, and I'm forgetting the other specialist.
Well, there are a few different that can siege fairly well, but mm-hmm. either way, you know, you're right. They've nailed the top three that are just lane bullies for sure. And now Tassadar and Tyrande, as they come out with that double support, neither hero healing particularly well, so they decide to run with two of them to try and make up for that, to try and keep Diablo not the most tanky of tanks, you know, a little squishy for what Diablo does, especially up to level 7 before he gets that big health boost. This should help him be able to stay alive better, and it's always nice to have that shield for Tracer as she jumps around. And now we also see Johanna coming out, the tank that we thought they would pick, but who is going to be their healer is the big question.
Right, and I'm wondering, where is Penguin's damage going to come from? Tracer does lay down damage, but it's more of a sustain and stick on you kind of mentality. But there is no burst from any of them. While they have a Kael'thas, who is probably one of the best burst heroes in the game, and I'm wondering who they're going to pick as a last pick here. It'll be interesting to see.
Yeah, you would think it would be a burst damage dealer. They've got, you know, but they don't have a whole lot of front line, so it's a question.
Mm-mm.
And Lili is going to be the healer for Avalanche. Very interesting. You know, Lili, kind of one of the simpler healers to play in the game, throws out decent numbers without a ridiculous amount of skill involved because of the auto-aiming nature of her heals. And just kind of a well-rounded team with a lot of siege potential so far for Avalanche. Let's see how Lingering Penguins decides to answer that with this last pick.
The Joe and Lili pick were, I believe, response towards Tracer with the blinds. So they're saying right now that most of their damage, they think most of the damage is going to be coming from Tracer, so we're going to blind her out. and reduce that damage amount. So it's going to be very interesting to see what Penguins is going to take here, because they have a couple of things. They have a Thrall, who would be a very solid pick to take right here, a Lunara, but again they have the blinds on the other team. The Rainer, the Vol, the same issue. They could take a Butcher here if they wanted to, along with a bunch of other damage dealers. But they pretty much, what Avalanche has done is said, you can take anybody except auto attackers. And here we are with the Jaina.
And there's the burst damage. You know, Jaina not played a whole lot because of the way Bolt of the Storm was taken away from her in her most recent update, which has been out for a little while, but Ice Block also being moved off of 13 to level 20 makes her a lot more squishy and susceptible to being jumped on. But, you know, how much chase potential and how much dive do Avalanche really have? You know, it doesn't seem like they're very scared of that at this point if they're going to go with Jaina as their main burst damage dealer.
Right. But this looks like it's going to be Jaina is going to be the top person to take down any of the terrors. And they needed to pick up somebody because Tracer wasn't going to do it.
Yeah, not enough damage.
For a long time. Right. So it's going to be interesting how they're going to play this, because looking at it, if we're going to take a guess who's going to win this match, I'm going to go with Avalanche here. I think they completely outdrafted Penguins with this kind of wonky comp that you see here, especially getting the KT pick, which was a misstep, in my opinion, on the side of Penguins.
Yeah, I tend to agree with that. You know, I think that this could actually be a little bit of a better match than we're giving it credit for off the draft, because they do have a lot of sustain. You know, Lingering Penguins with the double support comp are going to have as much or more sustain than that of Avalanche coming out with that Lili and that solo healer. And plus, you know, Zagara, Zol, Kael'thas, they're all kind of squishy in and of themselves. If they get caught out from the CC from Diablo, the follow-up from Tyrande, and and Jaina is actually probably got the biggest amount of burst damage in an AoE style in the game. They could give them a lot of trouble here. It's just a matter of whether or not they can keep up on sieging on the map, and whether or not they've really got an answer for the more damage that'll be coming out from Avalanche from not having the double support.
Right. One thing I'm interested to see is seeing how Avalanche handles their CC rotation between KT, Zul, and Zagara, especially when she gets the mod, if they're going to go that route. How are they going to play that? Are they going to be able to chain it very nicely, or is it going to turn into a hot mess of CC attempts? They have the potential of locking down pretty much anybody at any time with those three heroes.
All right, so we're loading into the game here. I'm going to make sure to get the names on the right side for everybody as we get going here. Small details.
As we go, yes, and I will make sure to get the first talent set up so we can list those off quickly.
Yeah, I think I might have got the bug fixed now to where they should show up on top with what the talents are going. Yep, looks like that's going to be the case here as all the question marks pop right on in. And here we are on Garden of Terror in the Blue Trunks. We're going to have Lingering Penguins, Diablo being played by O'Snap, Boomshard playing Tracer, Vinny the Fish playing Tassadar, Super Tails playing Tyrande, and I Love Lamp on Jaina. Would you like to introduce the red team there, partner?
I'm trying to get to it. I'm trying to figure it out. All right, we got Skeptic on KT, Faquans on Joe. Oh, good Lord. Can you give me the hard names?
Sure do.
Yeah, Boat. I'm going to just say Boat. Skip the J. Zagara, Totem, Lili, and Thugs on my boy Zul.
There you go. And we start off with a little bit of back and forth in the mid, as we usually see on big giant maps like this. Plenty of time to rotate to the top and the bottom. So we'll see if anybody gets caught out in the mid. Zul taking a couple steps forward. Stun's trying to come out, but not a whole lot. Not a whole lot there.
Tyrande got caught out just a little bit there, and I thought there could have been an opportunity for them to push on that, but they decided to back off.
And here comes the four-man rotation. They're going to try and catch out Jaina, and they catch her, and there it is. a great example of, you know, you, it probably wouldn't have happened against Li Ming, where she's got that blink talent, but Jaina, no escapes.
No, right. And especially with a Jaina, you should be having some excellent communication between the team. If you're going to pick a Jaina for your burst damage like the Penguins did, they have to communicate with her, letting her know where this team is. And what we can see now is that Avalanche is just going to be constantly rotating here between top and looks to be top and mid.
Yeah, not a whole lot of response coming out so far from Penguins. They are making the rotations to try and answer that, but they're definitely not as clean. They're definitely not moving around as fast.
So I'm going to try to quickly run through these really quickly, these talents, since I finally figured this all out. Diablo taking Soul Feast, Slipstream for his Tracer, Conjurer Pursuit for Tassadar, Ranger's Mark for Antaranda, and Conjurer Pursuit on Jaina.
And in the top half here, we're going to have Avalanche starting to go after this top set of seeds as they start to get a slight lead on the seeds. And of course, when we see on this map, you got two different options for going after the map objective, the top and the bottom half. Both have these seed terrors, have the little seed camps. So it just makes more sense that when you see four of these guys on this and they're owning it, the opposite team will usually just go to the other side of the map and get seeds on the other side.
And right now we're seeing that Penguins are having trouble taking down their Terra because Jaina has elected to stay top, and they're just finishing their Terra, and here we go with an invade here. So we have...
Yep, they're going to try and see if they can catch anybody out. Diablo is going to rush in to try and give himself a little bit of time, and it looks like he's going to end up biting the bullet for his team there.
Oh, maybe not with Vinny that Tassadar shield.
Vinny the Fish is going to get in there, give him that, and the root is going to come out from Zol.
Nope.
And that... Oh, nice. And the slide almost gets him out of there, but he will end up getting taken down, and Jaina gets out with... Taranda gets out with next to no health there.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, you were right. You know, the siege damage was not quite there because Jaina was up in top trying to get him level 4. And just a really, really strong rotation from Avalanche to get in there and try and interrupt some of that seeds. They didn't end up getting there before the seeds were taken, but they did end up getting to take down Diablo for their trouble there.
Right. So now we're seeing them going back to their lanes. Right now, bot lane looks to be getting pushed out by Zagara, and Penguin's response to that is Tassadar generally has pretty good laning abilities and being able to sniff out that creep, but he's already down to almost a quarter health. I don't know what they're going to try to do here with her.
Yeah, it looks like right now Zagara is just lane bullying here, and Tassadar is usually not a bad response to that. He can usually keeps that lane from going, you know, completely in the direction of the other team. He is a pretty strong solo laner, but... And here comes the response, the rotation from Lingering Penguins, and
nice.
Taranda and Tracer make short work of Zagara.
Penguins get on the board finally on the kill count with that Tracer, and I think that's what they need to do, is constantly have this Tracer moving around, again, with that communication, hey, I got somebody low in my lane, and then we should see a response from Tracer coming up here trying to finish off that kill. That might be pretty advantageous for Penguins to try to employ her.
For sure. I mean, Tracer is really good at just coming out of the mist and being able to lay a lot of damage out on somebody before they really have an opportunity to run. And even when they do run, she's one of the best chasers in the game.
Here we are with a rotation up top here with Diablo, but I think... Well, Lili might be coming out here. We'll see what we have here.
And Lili's going to get flipped and deleted by Jaina
right.
And Tracer. A lot of burst damage and sustained damage coming together there. They were kind of close to that siege camp. I was a little worried that they might sniff it out, but they do end up walking away with Lili either way.
Mm-hmm. Very nice, very nice. Interesting that Avalanche didn't respond quicker to the Lili's endangerment there, but they did get to the camp nonetheless.
Yeah, sometimes you got to choose, I suppose. I mean, that was a great flip by Diablo. He had a great response to Lili trying to get away there. Lili, usually one of the more slippery heroes in the game, but able to just flip her around and get that damage from the two assassins that were sitting right behind him. And they made very, very short work of Lili in that scenario. So not a whole lot going on here as we start to go into the next Shambler phase. We're going to see these seeds come out. Most of Avalanche are down here in the bottom in a good position to start on these bottom seeds after taking their siege camp. However, Vinny the Fish and Boombard, Tracer and Tassadar, going to get the left seeds at least. And
oh, no. Vinny just walked right past all those seeds there that Thugs just picked up. And even though that was just a couple, you know, three or so, four seeds, but that could be the difference between a terror or not having a terror.
Yeah, later on down the road, for sure.
Right.
And again, you know, just kind of each one of these teams just kind of deciding to settle for you know, one side of it. And as they both get to level 10 here, we're going to see the ults coming out.
Right. And if I can get my... So ults, what we have here today. Diablo is taking on Apocalypse, Tracer, Pulse Round, Force Wall for Tassadar, Shadowstalk for Tyrande, electing not to take the fall, Starfall. Jaina with the Ring of Frost, we expected to see that. Phoenix coming from KT, we're still waiting on Joe. Maw, of course, on Zagara. Cups on Lili, and we're still waiting on Zul.
Yep, Zul is hiding that. You know, usually we see Poison Nova coming out. Pretty standard picks across the board. You know, maybe a little bit surprised, as you alluded to there, that Tyrande in this double support comp decided to go with Shadowstalk, but we'll have to see how they decide to utilize that. With Jaina and Tracer, they may have enough damage on their side that as long as they keep the element of surprise, could work well for them. But now we got a terror fight going on in the mid.
Oh, very nice.
And they're going to get Zul off of that.
Absolutely. Zagara might be next.
And after being polymorphed there, she doesn't have a whole lot to defend herself with. She'll definitely get taken down. And now we're gonna see penguins start to finally rotate down and start to get damage on this terror, but a lot of damage done to the mid lane.
Absolutely. And right now, as we look at it, penguins has now taken the lead on the kill count with 4 kills to 2 kills from Avalanche. We're starting to see a little bit of that momentum shift towards lingering penguins. Let's see if they can keep it up here. But we do have the terror still at the top for Avalanche.
Yeah, they're definitely getting a lot of siege damage out here, where I don't feel like penguins got very much done with their terror.
Absolutely.
They got some kills, they got some fights in the mid, but at the end of the day, that terror was gone before they got any real siege damage. So they got a little bit of XP off of it with the kills. But a lot
Phoenix
more.
Phoenix coming out by KT here.
Yeah, they're gonna pressure this mid fourth. They're gonna try and force it. Diablo charging back to try and peel off. And the Apoc coming out is gonna hit all four members there, other than Johanna. And in the back, we see Tracer trying to put a lot of pressure on KT. But the team comes back and answers to that. Lili getting the heals out, able to save him.
Oh, very nice.
But Zul goes down to Jaina. And finally, I think they're going to force Avalanche here to kind of to start to retreat. But we did see Diablo for Zul, and as Diablo comes back really quickly with those souls, that's definitely a big plus for the side of Lingering Penguins. They were able to actually defend this mid fort as well.
What I just saw there in that engagement was when Jaina puts out her initial burst, drops her initial burst damage, Blizzard and Cone and all that. That's it for a while. I felt that the ults that Penguins put down were really, really good, but there just was no follow-up. And that's just showing how the lack of damage that they have on this team, with Jaina being pretty much it and Tracer being your cleanup. And I'm not sure, as the match goes on, is that gap between the teams and their damage output, is that going to increase or not?
Well, and that makes a lot of sense. You know, with Jaina, she's got very high damaging abilities, but they're also on a pretty high cooldown. And so,
exactly.
You know, she can go in, she can throw her abilities down, and maybe Tracer can try and get in there to clean up. But what else do they really have as far as follow-up?
They don't. And that's probably part of the reason why Jaina is not really considered meta right now. And right now, we've got a big, big push in the top lane here. Looks like that Avalanche is going to be taking that top fort down before transferring down to the seeds, and they're going to be able to get all the seeds in the top with no follow-up from Penguins.
Well, we've got Penguins in the mid, so it looks like they're going to actually try to rotate top here to see if they can contest these top seeds. Choosing to contest rather than just choosing to walk away and get the bottom seeds, they put a lot of initial damage out on Avalanche, and they're actually going to get the first kill with Zul.
Yeah, absolutely. But they are pretty low. We're going to have to try to get out of here. But it looks like Avalanche is trying to look for a follow-up here, but they're just not having it.
And Zagara trying to get around, but she actually gets body blocked in.
Wow.
by the siege camp. And they're able to capitalize on that, getting Tracer in there real quick to blow her up before she's able to waddle around that siege giant.
I think that Penguins definitely won that engagement there, but they elected to go to the top seeds versus the bottom seeds, where I think is a mistake because there's also a side camp on the bottom seeds that they did not get, and they're actually going to get less seeds here.
Absolutely. Yeah, that probably would have been the smarter approach, but then you also got to look at where Avalanche was going to end up going.
It's true.
And whether or not they wanted to make an engagement there. But Zol is getting caught out again as Tracer, Diablo, and Jaina are on the chase. They are going to answer to this, but Vinny the Fish coming in with their Terror to try and get a little battling going on here. Yet again, electing to battle with the Terror instead of
Apoc
pushing
it. Apoc is still up on here. We're looking for the Apoc here. He still has it, so we'll see if we get it to come out.
I'm actually seeing Apoc on 14 seconds still for cooldown.
Okay, but, I'm not showing that on mine.
Yeah, this UI might be a little screwy yet. We'll have to figure that one out. But in the meantime, it looks like both teams generally just walking away. Vinny the Fish going to take that Terror up to mid to see if they can maybe put a little bit of pressure on either mid or top here. Seeing as how Avalanche is on bottom and pressuring those bottom seeds, makes more sense for him to go to the top. And that's what he's going to do.
Jaina needs to get herself out of there, which she does. And Penguin's electing to go to the top lane with that Terror, which is very, very good. Vinny the Fish looking to take on that, finally taking down that top fort right there, putting out a seed along with bashing that fort in.
And it's going to be very close whether or not they actually get this fort down. It looks like KT is going to rotate in time. And it's going to knock down, and Zol is going to have a lot of help there too. From his skeletons coming out. But they are going to go put a little bit of pressure on the mid fort, but Tassadar is going to have to really get out of there quick. But he, with his slippery abilities, a good person to have in the Terror. He's able to get out of there pretty quickly.
Absolutely. And since they had another support, they're not losing so much on that end. But Diablo elected to go in first.
And they came out with the Shadow Stalk. They went in to engage. A lot of damage coming out, but with Lili's Cups able to keep everybody up, the Apoc is going to catch four members, the entire back line. And now they're going to try to chase in, but because of that Apoc, they got a lot of good zoning. But Diablo is going to stay a little bit too long and is going to end up paying with his life, even though he did have the souls to come back. So he's going to be coming right back into this match.
So we'll see if we're going to try to continue this engagement or that we're just going to split off and try to continue, take a breather, get some mana, get some health back. But it looks like Penguins is trying to chase with this and let's see what happens.
Yeah, Jaina trying to put a little bit of pressure on Zagara. Didn't do a whole lot. Again, with this, she just didn't take a whole lot of damage there. I feel like unless Jaina's really up close and close enough to hit you with Cone of Cold and Blizzard and Frostbolt rather than just one or two of those abilities, she doesn't get a whole lot of work done. And again, such long cooldowns there, it makes it really hard to play the game with Jaina right now. She's pretty much all burst.
And we're seeing Avalanche taking down, invading on Team Penguin's side of the map and taking down their camp right here. And they're going to get it cleanly with no contest.
Yeah, Tassadar does finally sniff that out with his passive, but it's a little bit too late as they had already invaded and taken that down. Now they're going to rotate up to mid, and they're going to take out the siege camp, and they got two more camps they can rotate up to there.
This is a smart move, trying to make Penguins have to choose what camp to go to, and right now with the XP lead leading onto the side of I can't remember. Avalanche, I got my colors all mixed up, so it's hard for me to tell who's who. I'm not sure if this is a good idea because they're missing it on the XP.
Yeah, right now I actually have Lingering Penguins, the blue team here. They got a little bit of an XP lead. But we are going to see them pressuring that bottom keep. It looks like they're going to actually get this here.
Right. And I'm, how much of work is those Bruiser camps going to get on top lane letting Penguins take down that bottom keep. Is there going to be a trade-off there or not? Well, we'll see how that works out.
Yeah, they got a long way to go before they get to the keep front wall, but a whole lot of time probably to do it as this seed phase is starting. And I don't see lingering Penguins going all the way up there to clear that anytime soon with seeds to grab.
I really, really, really like what Joe is doing down here on the side of Avalanche, invading on their Penguin side of the map there for the seeds. But Penguins coming in for the invade on top lane here.
Yeah, and they don't have Johanna. Johanna coming in late to this, but she's going to come right into the back line. They stack the Condemn on top of the Maw there, but Ring of Frost is going to come out, but Diablo is going to get blown up before this gets too far in. Taronda goes down, and again, they are pushing him out of here. Zol does go down, though.
Absolutely.
So it ends up being a 2-for-1, and we're going to see a pause.
Yes, we do have a pause. Maybe someone dropped.
It could very well be.
So it looks like right here that right now, Avalanche seems to be having the initiative over lingering Penguins, and I can't see because of the menu is right over it, but I think they might have caught up in XP, and it'll be interesting to see how they're going to push this, because right now they have the advantage over Penguins.
Yeah, it looks like we're seeing somebody with a little bit of lag here on the side of Avalanche.
Yeah, that I've been seeing that more and more. I know you have too, Jay. I wonder what will be, if any, will be Blizzard's response to fix this, because there's plenty of other games that are like this that does not experience as much lag or drops, and it'd be nice to see them finally have an answer to it.
Yeah, and I'm not sure where exactly that's coming from, but we have seen, we personally, and a lot of our team league nights have seen more players just having issues, especially logging into the game. It's not usually as much mid-game, but that's definitely been our experience thus far. We've seen a lot of issues with that. But let's go ahead and just take a look at the talents real quick while we've got a quick second to catch up here.
Absolutely. So right now both teams we have the side of Avalanche all the way are already at 20. KT taken Fel and Fusion, no surprise there. Regeneration, I'm sorry, I'm reading the wrong direction. Sun King's Fury for KT, excuse me. Blessed Hammer. No, wait a minute, am I reading it the wrong side?
Well, it looks like we're going to get back into the game either way.
Never mind, I'll do it a little bit later.
We'll look at it later, just like always.
That's
too much, action going on, what can we say? And it looks like we're going to immediately see a rotation by Avalanche to try and get this front wall as you pointed out, the camp had pushed to it, but it looks like they're going to give a lot of trouble to Johanna here as Vinny the Fish, again, coming out with that terror, using it and taking out one of the enemy heroes on Avalanche as they catch Johanna.
Absolutely.
Out.
And Vinny's trying to do with the chase method here to see if he can cut down anybody, but it looks like Avalanche might be able to get away from here. Vinny now taking the terror down to mid lane to see if they can get some kind of sort of push here. And get a bigger XP lead right now.
And KT looked like he might be being caught out a little bit as Tracer comes in, and he is going to get that kill. Vinny turns around, slaps him a couple of times, and with the damage from Tracer, that's just a little bit too much for him to handle.
Absolutely. Caught out a little bit there, and now it looks like Penguins has a little bit of an advantage going on here.
Yeah, knowing that KT and Johanna are down, they feel pretty safe. Pushing with the terror in one lane and sending four of their members to go up and get the seeds from the top Chambler.
Mm-hmm.
And they are going to get that top four at the same time.
Right, Penguins hitting that 20 mark first. A very, very interesting key with the take here. So we got Diablo taking Boltstorm. We got Total Recall on Tracer. Storm Shield for Tassadar. Storm Shield again for Tyranda. And we're still waiting on the Jaina pick.
Yeah, pretty standard level 20 talents there. The storm talents coming out. A lot of sustain here with double storm shield. They're going to be able to sustain in these fights a lot, and that's kind of what we've been seeing is when lingering Penguins have been winning team fights, it's because they've just been outlasting their opponents and poking them down until they finally find somebody low, and then Tracer or Jaina just get in there and knock them out. And a nice invade there to go get their siege camp before Avalanche was able to actually go get their terror and turn off all of the siege camps.
What I really would have liked to have seen Penguins do there, since they had initially a two-level lead there, look for a fight. Pick a fight somewhere. And they elected to go to that camp and blow a little bit of that lead. Now, they still have a bit of a level lead, being one level higher, and they have their 20s talents. But they really need to be aggressive here and try to take this fight.
Yeah, the Storm talents, other than maybe the heroics, are definitely the biggest. And we do see the Skeletal Magels coming out from Zul there as they try and push this forward. And they are going to try and push this front wall, but a big team fight's going to come out. APOC comes out, hits a couple members. Cups to respond to try and sustain here. Ring of Frost comes out and hits the Terror and two of the back line, and Zul is going to get blown up. And Diablo's in a lot of trouble from the Terror, but will bolt out safely, and it looks like the teams are going to try to walk away. But Lingering Penguins is on the chase. Tracer jumps back in and is going to get a little bit of harass out on Li Ming before she steps back. Diablo is going to flip the Terror and is going to pay with his life for it. KT a little caught out there, but the team's response is pretty good as they come back and push him away. An aggressive bolt in here by Zagara, and now all of a sudden it's Avalanche with those level 20 Storm talents trying to re-engage on him here.
Absolutely. A little bit of a chase coming on the side of Lingering Penguins. That might have been questionable. However, as we kind of reset and we get ourselves collected and they get mana back, we got them taking a camp here. We're looking at the Storm Talents for Master of Flames for KT, Storm Shield for Joe, Bolt Storm for Zagara, Kung Fu Hustle for Li Li, and Bone Spear for Zul.
And they will invade both of these bottom camps. They are going to end up taking the Siege Camp and then the Bruiser Camp from the side of Lingering Penguins, and it looks like now they're heading towards their siege camp in the back. So they won that team fight, and what do you do after those team fights? You go after Merc Control. You capitalize on the map, paint the map your color.
That's absolutely right. And we'll see if Zul is going to try to go up and get that top Bruiser camp or just come back down. He is going to come back down to group up with his team.
Yeah, and that leaves Lingering Penguins pretty much just with the option of trying to clean up these lanes so that their structures don't take too much damage. And we've got that mule coming out from Taronda trying to heal up the mid. But they will go up and get their siege camps. And now we got about 20 seconds where these teams are going to be antsy to try and do something.
Oh, we got a bait maybe.
Well, a little bit. They're going to sniff this out. Here comes the Shadow Stalk, but a great shield coming out there to reveal most of the team.
Oh, Taronda has been caught out.
And Taronda looks like she is in a lot of trouble. She's going to get rooted by Zul and blown up, swallowed up into that team, and there's not a whole lot that Lingering Penguins could do for her there.
No. As the team moved up into the top lane, she stayed near the Terror spawning point, and they just were able to sniff her out and just get rid of her.
Yep.
And now she's down for 47 seconds, so they're going to have to move quickly to get these seeds or try to defend the keep. And either way, I feel that Avalanche definitely has the advantage here. They might be able to get two Terrors out of this.
Yeah, it's funny how one death this phase in the game can make such a huge difference in these coordinated team matches. But it's really true. You know, they're left with only being able to go down and try and start on these Terrors after clearing that bottom so that the bottom keep front wall doesn't take too much damage. But here comes the invade. They're going to go on the aggressive side.
Wow,
they're going to rotate around.
Nicely done.
Diablo sniffs them out, and suddenly Lingering Penguins is on the run. And Diablo and Jaina are in a lot of trouble here. All five of them are coming in on this, and their team is not here with them. The Shadow Stalk is going to come out to try and help them out. The APOC is going to slow up at least Zagara and Kael'thas. And it looks like they are going to get out of this. They actually turn on Zul and get a lot of damage, but Diablo is getting low. Diablo is going to get killed, and Zul is going to actually walk away from this. But
yes,
Diablo
yes,
is going to come back. He did have enough souls. So for all the trouble that rotation was giving them, the split up, they actually came out of that without taking too much damage. But again, Avalanche is going to take what they can advantage-wise out of that, and they're going to go get some more seats.
And we see a re-engage here on this team battle hill, and Zagara getting singling out here. Let's see what they can take him down.
Yeah, all five of them are coming back while Zul was not here with them. And Zagara is going to get taken down. Good call there. She got caught out, and she got taken out while they were grabbing the Terror. And that's going to be so KT in the Terror once again. So they didn't have KT or Zol there, so that made it a pretty easy invade for Lingering Penguins. But meanwhile, they have a pretty quick rotation to the mid on the side of Avalanche to get in here and try and get some damage on this front keep.
And Terra going, deciding to go up to top lane to see if he can take down the rest of that wall and maybe pressure that keep a little bit more. But it looks like Penguins, now they're starting to respond up to the top lane.
Yeah, and so what Penguins are electing to do is to send their Terror to try and go get some siege damage himself, trusting these four members to be able to fend off this attack. And Avalanche is seeing that, looks like they're trying to decide whether or not to answer to that.
Which I think is a smart call. Penguins has got to do something here, and having that Terror push, and just, as of right now, we're still not seeing a response. Oh, now we see Zagara starting to respond to that, and it looks like Avalanche is going to start backing off from their base.
Taronda getting in a little bit of trouble there, and it looks like they're finally going to poke this this Terror down before it gets back. But and oh snap, with a really great bolt out as Diablo to save his own life there. But there's the re-engage on that mid keep. Meanwhile, in the back, Vinny the Fish is getting some work done on this, but Zagara is also fending it off. Ring of Frost comes out and will catch three members, but not really any follow-up there, as Tracer and Diablo both go down, and this could be pressure onto the core.
That's right, this could be it. Just depending on how this last little bit of the team fight works out, they could really get a lot of core damage done on this thing.
But it looks like they're looking at just taking a few steps back and waiting for this Terror to go down. It's got little to no health, but until Vinny of the Fish actually either steps out of that thing or has it die, or has the last 6 seconds run out, they can't start the camps. So they will actually rotate to it, take it down, and try and catch Tassadar. It's going to be a little rough. Tassadar is one of the hardest heroes in the game to actually chase down and kill. The invulnerability is coming out, and the double storm shield paying off there as they're able to keep Vinny the Fish up.
Very nice. I thought for sure Vinny was going to die there at the bottom of the lane, but his team did a nice job to help and get him out of there. And we got a mule coming out on a couple of the towers on that wall and trying to heal it if it's back up.
Meanwhile, they're going to take a step back is Avalanche, and they're going to go after this camp. They're going to get it before we see the response. They do sniff out that they are there, and we are going to see yet another pause. Like somebody yet again on the side of Avalanche might be lagging here.
All right. So it looks like it's KT. Skeptic is having some lag issues right here.
I got to say, though, partner, if this is how they're playing with lag, I'd hate to see them with no lag.
Absolutely.
Kind of rough.
600 ping coming from Joanna, I'm assuming. That is, wow. Wow. So we're seeing a lot of pressure here with Avalanche pushing in on the bottom, already taking down the mid-keep. And the towers and walls are already gone for the top keep. So we're going to soon see here with these merc camps coming out that they're going to try to paint map their color with those mercenary pickups. That Penguins is going to have an incredible amount of pressure put on them, and it's going to be interesting to see how they try to respond to this.
And I apologize to the stream. You guys aren't going to get this apology for a few minutes because of the delay, but I'm going to go ahead and put up the statistics. That's working on trying to get into this a little bit more, but that's really good feedback that I appreciate. We got the individual statistics up now with, of course, you know, who else but KT, top hero damage, though he has also had those terrors, so the siege damage numbers and the hero damage numbers are also contributed by those terrors that just wallop people, but still definitely top for both siege damage and hero damage for Avalanche. And we're also seeing Jaina with top siege damage and hero damage on side of Lingering Penguins.
Right, and it's interesting to note that Jaina for her respective team and KT for his respective team both are having the siege damage, which is really interesting about KT. We have two siege specialists on the side of Avalanche, and KT is able to out-siege all of them.
Well, and KT's numbers are also contributed from the Terror. So that's a really big part of it. I think the Terror's been getting a lot of that.
That's true.
Picking up that
Absolutely.
Siege damage. But the fact that they've got so much siege damage across the board where, you know, Zol and Zagara have such high siege damage numbers without ever having stepped into the Terror is a really big deal. It's a pretty good strategy on their end for putting their most squishy character and KT in the Terror so that he's under the least amount of risk as they go in and have to go into these team fights with their Terror.
Right, and that Zul with over 120 K siege damage, and Kael'thas with his 175, that's just an unruly amount of siege damage coming on from the side of Avalanche. And the response that we have is Diablo actually has a pretty nice amount of siege damage with 128, but Jaina being able to, with that burst with 147 K siege damage. Interesting to note, too, with Jaina, she has 70 K hero damage, who is out damaging KT, again, probably most likely because he's in the Terror. He's not being able to drop all those AoEs with only 64,000 hero damage.
Right, and it seems like to me that Vinny the Fish, if I'm not mistaken, has been in 100% of those Terrors for the side of Lingering Penguins as Tassadar. So that's where all his siege damage is coming from. And yet Jaina is still laying out more siege damage, and Diablo actually coming out with a pretty impressive amount of siege damage. But I think a lot of that has to do with his build. Let me go ahead and switch over to the talents right now. With Fire Devil, Firestorm, and Rampage really stepping up the Fire Stomp, getting him a lot of extra siege damage on minions, mercenaries, and the structures.
That's great. With that, we're looking at basically an almost virtually tie. It is a tie with the structures being up. You could argue right now that Avalanche has the bit of the momentum push with taking that camp right there on Penguin's side of the map. But structure-wise, we're looking at a virtual tie here. Even though you could argue that Avalanche might be having more momentum, longer momentum in this match than Penguin.
Yeah, and the level advantage is not really all that high. It is kind of covered up by the pause button here. But if I remember correctly, they're both 21, 22, somewhere in that range. So it's not very high, and the death count is nearly the same, 12 to 11 right now. And as you quoted, two structures there. The only difference is it looks like right now Avalanche is in a little bit of a better position as we get started back in here to start getting more siege camps.
And right now we got Avalanche taking the siege camp on the bottom half of Team Penguin's side of the map here, and what we're going to see now is Avalanche probably going back and grabbing their camps as well and waiting for the next. Here comes the next knight.
Well, they got a 4-man rotation. They're looking at getting up and getting this last siege camp on their side. Zul is going to rotate up and around. We'll have to see if Lingering Penguins wants to invade this. It looks like they do. They've got Shadowstalk. They could do this a little bit stealthy, and they do hit Shadowstalk, but it's a little bit too late. They show, and the team fight is going to break out, though. The Apoc coming out. Lili is going to finally hit that cups, but it's a little bit too late to save Zagara. Getting a lot of value healing out of KT here, but KT gets separated from Lili, and Tracer just gets blown up as well. So overall, not too terrible in exchange, but they do end up getting Zul before that team fight is over, and that ends up being a 2-for-1 exchange on the side of Lingering Penguins.
Right, and right now the best thing that Penguins can do right here, I feel, is try to get as much of these seeds and get another Terror. Right now they have a higher seed count than Avalanche, but if they can push another Terror and then push with it, if Avalanche does not have their Terror, this could be turn out to be a very monumentous position for Penguins.
And I can't help but notice, partner, but up in the top left, nobody captured that Siege Giant camp. It's been defeated, but no one's actually stepped on it to capture it yet.
No, absolutely. We'll see what happens here.
We'll see who's the first one who ends up discovering that as we see another pause. Oh, my.
Oh, boy. I got a lot less things to talk about nowadays since we've had three pauses here.
Well,
so how's your day going?
I'm not going to lie. Being a first-time cast, this is my first day actually getting to cast. I don't really mind the breaks. I'm not going to lie, but I'm worried the audience might be a little bit up in arms, but we'll have to see how that turns out.
Right.
Like, it does give me a second to actually look up on the screen and see a little bit of the chat, though. By the way, thanks for joining us, guys. This is going to be our last match casting because we get to play a little bit later on tonight, about a little over an hour.
Mm-hmm. And right now we're seeing these the minions come walking in on Penguin's side of the base, and they're going to have to make a decision here if they're going to all stick around and take down that Terror quickly or make some kind of response to this a minion issue, especially in that top lane with the mount. And then, of course, like you said, who's the team that's going to notice those siege not being taken yet?
Yeah, with the range of these pauses, I'm a little bit worried that somebody might tip them off from the stream, even with a 3-minute delay.
Right.
Oh no.
Right.
But I guess things like that just can't be helped.
No, it happens. there could be a lot of different issues with this. I mean, this could be obviously a game issue, or it could be, I think someone mentioned that they might be playing in different locations across the world. We don't know. These teams are located, and that could be an issue that could be happening right here with this. I'm amazed, if that is the case, I'm amazed how long we've gone before we started getting this. We had a good 10 or so, 15 minutes of gameplay before the lag really started happening with these pauses.
Yeah, this is becoming one of those classic Garden of Terror matches. On average, one of the highest matches in terms of match length, and it just, some of these just drag on forever because of the nature of the objectives. The fact that, you know, each team can pretty easily get one, and more often than not does end up getting, you know, one each, which can lead to people deciding to fight over the terrors instead. You know, fight each other and not even really take full advantage of these terrors actually pushing and taking structures, which is what they're designed to do, but instead using them for team fighting.
Right. And then when you get the team, you know, one terror pushing one lane, and the other team's terror is pushing on their base, you know, how do you delegate that balance between who's defending the terror against their terror and then attacking the other terror? It's really going to be interesting to see how they do this here. But it looks right here as we start this that Penguins is going to be, excuse me, Avalanche. I'm going to get them right. No, Penguins is going to be getting their terror first. And if Avalanche is not careful, they may not be able to get a terror at all in this particular exchange.
Yeah, we'll have to see. I mean, it looks like right now Avalanche is in a pretty good position to finish taking this camp with the three they do have and then go up and try and get this Shambler. But at the same time, you know, four members of Lingering Penguins are up right now, and they've already started on this side camp. They have four members to be able to try and take this down really quickly, their Shambler. They could then, with Tracer just 16 seconds out, she can move across the map faster than most heroes. She can try to ride in there, and they can try and meet top. But by then, we'll also have Zagara, and Zul should be on his way back. So we'll have to see how these teams decide to handle this. There's also the factor that we've got a couple of the catapults pushing in the bottom for Avalanche, and another wave on the way. So we'll have to see. Interesting how this is, how the minion wave is so spread out here. I'm kind of wondering what would have in this bottom lane have this catapult so far out from the rest of the wave. But either way, okay. So it looks like we do have one of the players loading back in.
He's 5 minutes, five,
five, five and a half minutes behind. So that's not. That's not a literal 5.5 minutes. Like, it won't take that long. It's just that the game has to take time to catch up and reload in.
Which will be interesting to see if the Blizzard will be able to come up with some sort of other mechanic for rejoins, because a lot of the criticism that comes to this game, besides the lag issue, is the amount of time it takes to rejoin a match. It's nice that right here everything is paused, but as we know, when someone DCs in a public match, it is taken over by the computer, and sometimes the computer will take wrong talents or do not so advantageous things. So hopefully soon, someday, we see Blizzard somehow address this issue.
And we see a little bit of joking going on between these two teams, trying to pass the time while the lag issues try to resolve themselves.
And hopefully this will be the last lag issue that we have for the map.
We can pray, you know.
Right. And I'm getting a feeling that one more good team fight The winner of that fight will be able to push Core and win this match. So it's going to be very interesting to see how these teams are going to play with so much at stake at this particular point in the match.
For sure. And I'll tell you, I'm glad I didn't decide to sign up for an 8 o'clock game because, you know, I'd be running late to cast that one. So I guess we'll just we'll have about an hour to warm up for our match and get ready to go for our second placement match.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, we'll see how this works out with them. Hopefully those will get resolved shortly.
Everyone follow me on Instagram. That's nice. That's nice. a little self-promotion going on here while we're waiting for these games to restart. Yeah, I actually, I'm still trying to get more familiar with the chair league rules. I'm not sure if there are any rules like ESL has with lag issues and whether there's a limit. Though I suppose if the two teams are willing to wait, then there's no real reason to make things too serious. This is, after all, labeled as recreational HOTS. We're not playing for trips to, you know, to
Korea
or anything.
No, but
at the same time, you know, you do want to keep it at a reasonable pace. And again, we see
a disconnect.
Farquhar leaving. Yeah, that is very unfortunate here. At some point, I do think that at the very least, etiquette would dictate that we go ahead and move on with the match, but. I guess that's going to be up to the two teams.
Right.
How do you even get ping that high?
Now it's down to 6K.
All right. Well, you know, progress, I suppose. But still a long way to go before that issue's fixed.
Mm-hmm.
I'm starting to think we should put on some Carbot animations for these people while we're waiting.
Oh, absolutely. You know, my endorsement there up, and now we're down to 3K.
Okay. Well, progress. You know, partner, I think I'm just gonna go for it. I'm not gonna lie.
Go ahead.
All right, let's see if I can set this up.
You know, as soon as you do this, it's gonna start, right?
Well, that's the idea. You know, I want to get these match. I want to get this match started for these people. So I want to go ahead and get this rolling by putting up a Carbot video, and you know, letting them roll. Let's see if I can find our Heroes of the Storm ones, because you know those. That's got to be what fits the best.
We left the game. Dropped the game again. Let's get the KT bot video.
Well, you know, it makes just as much sense to start from the very first one, though. We got Rainer with aspiring to inspire. That's going to be the first ever one. There we go, and all right, here we go. Carbot animations. Enjoy, guys. We'll bring you back into the game as soon as we're ready.
Hey, man. I can dig that. Ready to start this show? Fill 'em full of daylight. Yeehaw! Let's light 'em up. Hit 'em hard and fast. Yippee-ki-yay. Go on the offensive. Hell yeah! We got this. Hey, man.
Hey, guys, this is Carbot Animations, and we hope you enjoy.
Now, you shall know.
It looks like we're back on.
We are definitely back on. Thank goodness. Back into the game we go. And Johanna is back in the game, and we are back here on Garden of Terror. See, and it's like you said, you know, as soon as I started the Carbot animations video, that fixed the whole problem.
Looks like Avalanche is going to get that siege camp that was left.
Somebody was creeping on the stream. We're not going to lie.
I know, probably. If you look right here, Penguins at their base now is looking at two catapults and two siege mercenaries here with that shield just dropping like a rock.
Yeah, forgive me for the bad joke, but the only thing they're missing up there is the partridge and the pear tree. Yeah, okay, that was a bad joke. I'll try and refrain from
we
that.
We see the too. Phoenix come out, but then we all of a sudden see
Zul's... And they just go straight to Core Rush. Wow. And that is going to be game. They were ready for that. They were ready on that replay to just go straight into it. They realized that they had all that pressure going. They were either going to get a keep out of that or... coming off that pause, Lingering Penguins was just not ready. They Core Rushed right to it.
Absolutely, they did. And obviously, they had a little conversation privately with each other about what they're going to do coming off that pause, which is what you're supposed to do. And you would have thought, Avalanche having that conversation, you would have thought Penguins would have had some sort of response ready, seeing how much pressure they were about to get, and we just didn't see it. We just didn't see it. They should have been on the defense, on their base, getting ready to defend it instead of going after the Terror.
Yeah, and you know, a lot of mistakes like that will happen during the game, where you get so caught up in the map objectives, you end up focusing a little bit too much on that, and not so much on what's going on the core or on different structures. And you're right, you know, you think that would have served as an advantage for Lingering Penguins to know that, hey, you know, we don't really need the seeds right now. A top priority should be trying to answer to all this pressure, and we just didn't see that out of them. They didn't use the pause there as effectively. It's kind of a bummer way to put it, but you know, I'm calling it like I see it, I suppose. But a 30-minute game, a very, very long game.
And I really want to say that Lingering Penguins, I really thought that even though we thought that their draft picks might have been a little bit questionable, we did see them use them to a very positive and advantageous way. They did a real nice job battling toe-to-toe with Avalanche with that comp, even though Jaina was pretty much that one damage dealer. And if we did not have these pauses occur, you know, we just don't know what would have happened. So I really give kudos to Penguins, knowing their comp that they were trying to use here, and knowing how to play their characters very well.
Yeah, and we actually see Avalanche coming out with a win there. So congratulations to them. Congratulations to Lingering Penguins for putting up their dukes and fighting the big fight, and especially waiting patiently for those pauses. You know, it's nice to see good sportsmanship coming out from both of those teams. Where you know, it's just nice to see people not freaking out about pauses and about technical issues, because those things happen in these kind of games, especially when we're not playing in LAN events. You know, people are all over the country and really all over the world to play this game, and so, you know, those kind of issues do happen for sure.
Absolutely. So kudos, good job on Avalanche getting the win, and great job with Penguins there trying to battle it toe to toe, right there.
Yeah, well, that's going to be it for us tonight. Thank you so much for joining us, guys. It's been a pleasure to cast for you. We plan on coming back and casting again soon, except maybe this time we'll swap the roles and Plague will be on his stream and I'll be joining him. But thanks again for joining us. Please feel free to subscribe if you like what you see. We'll be casting a lot in the future for Chair League and maybe beyond. Who knows? You never know in this the way this new game is starting out. So thanks for joining us, and we'll see you next time.
See you guys.